Could artificial intelligence development lead society to a state of neo-nihilism or new nihilism soon? Meaning in the coming years, will people struggle to find meaning and purpose in their lives, despite having more free time than ever, due to widely successful A.N.I. or artificial narrow intelligence and A.G.I. artificial general intelligence systems running most of our lives for us and solving most of our problems? Now, that might sound counterintuitive, but this video will look at one dark possibility our future could become soon thanks to theoretically successful AI development. Now, if it's interesting or helpful, please comment below. I'm sure, as you know by now, that helps get these types of videos seen. The philosopher Nietzsche was the first to seriously write about nihilism, which he saw as a state of despair and frustration due to individuals no longer finding meaning and purpose in their lives. For many, their meaning and purpose in life came from outside sources, like religion, which during the Enlightenment, many were beginning to question as truth. He wrote, "Nihilism appears at that point, not that the displeasure of existence has become greater than before, but because no one has come to mistrust any meaning in suffering, indeed in existence. It now seems as if there is no meaning at all in existence, as if everything were in vain." In a nutshell, he thought the solution to overcoming nihilism was to create your own meaning by focusing on self-improvement and working toward goals we set for ourselves. By striving to get better at a job or a creative pursuit we're interested in, like struggling to become a better artist, we create our own meaning, contributing to better psychological health. The meaning we derive isn't really from accomplishing any specific task, but more from the struggle and journey, he thought. Only great pain is the ultimate liberator of the spirit. I doubt that such pain makes us better, but I know it makes us more profound. And in many ways, society has defeated Nietzsche's nihilism. Studies into human well-being show that deriving a sense of meaning from things like a job that matters to us and working on creative pursuits seem to contribute to a better life. Today, we're on the cusp of creating the most important invention of man, AGI, which will undoubtedly change society drastically for better or for worse. Now, ANI, artificial narrow intelligence, it already exists, and it's found in things like the DALL-E 2 art generator, ChatGPT application. AGI, or strong artificial intelligence, is a software that has the ability to understand or learn any intellectual task that a human being can, including creativity. The broad intellectual capacities of AGI would exceed human capacities because of its ability to access and process huge data sets at incredible speeds and lack of needs, meaning it never has to stop working. AI companies like OpenAI, Alphabet, and more are rapidly pursuing the creation of AGI, not just for short-term profit, but because many of their founders believe or have convinced themselves that AGI will be highly beneficial for all of us one day. AI and AGI systems can become so powerful we'll be able to stop working jobs and have more time for creative pursuits and activities that increase human well-being, like working on art or writing. But what if A.N.I. and A.G.I. systems are so successful they become far more creative and better artists and the best team of creative humans combined? What if they become better at every goal-oriented human activity to the point that performing many goal-oriented tasks ourselves without A.I. would be considered unethical or even no longer possible? Well, there's two responses you generally get from asking this type of question. Number one, A.G.I. will never outperform humans in every goal-oriented task or replace human creativity. And number two, even if AGI were to outperform humans in every goal-oriented task, it wouldn't stop us from pursuing them for pure enjoyment anyway. Now let's take a closer look at why I worry both these responses are flawed. First, unless there's something mystical outside the known laws of physics in regards to how the human mind works, there's no reason to think self-learning technology can't function and perform everything a human mind can do. Now, take creativity. You know, there's this feeling that while AI can create new art, it will never be able to be creative like human artists. You know, only search and borrow from previous human creations, like the current DALL-E system does right now. But what is human creativity really? Well, it's simply the ability to construct new patterns or ways of organizing information based on previous data. All of our creative works draw on things that have already existed, and we are just better at finding new patterns than AI at the moment. No one has yet to invent, you know, a new color other than the ones that have been in existence, for example. The more sophisticated AGI becomes, the more likely it will match human creativity or even surpass it. But, you know, even if AGI were to outperform humans in every goal-oriented task, that wouldn't stop us from pursuing them for pure enjoyment, right? Well, of course, we'll have the ability to pursue them, but if we're not careful with AI development over the next year or so, we may find the meaning and significance we would normally derive from such creative pursuits severely damaged. Yes, we can still, you know, paint a painting by ourselves without AI technology, but we may find ourselves in a world where it feels pointless, or, you know, if we do it, it's not nearly as meaningful to us as it was pre-AI. Why is that? Well, here's a few reasons that come to mind. Number one, meaning comes from struggle. As Nietzsche clearly articulated, the meaning we find in our work is in the suffering required to accomplish it. You know, if you just type a keyword and create an amazing painting, that's great, but it's no longer that meaningful anymore. You didn't put any thought or effort into its creation. Perhaps more importantly, though, is that AGI isn't just about doing any goal-oriented task for us. It's probably going to be crucial in researching, teaching, and helping us execute the task, too. There's this multi-prong effect happening where we're still relying on technology to assist us even though we're still doing the goal-oriented activity. For example, you might enjoy playing chess because it's fun to improve and work on getting better, playing against others. But if there are AI programs that teach people how to become grandmasters quickly, including doing the strategy, helping us optimize our bodies and minds for playing the game, you know, our chess journey is going to feel less meaningful. You know, we've essentially become code that carries out what AGI tells us to do. And those that win, they simply just did what AI systems instructed a little bit better. Now, at what point do humans just become the software script needed to carry out the task, while AGI does the heavy lifting, you know, including the teaching, the strategy, the instruction, and far more? Number two, there may not be any significant demand for human-generated art. Now, as the software will become far more creative and execute better and produce far more works of art in less time, there may not be any demand for purely generated human art. If AGI can write a fiction book, including coming up with relatable characters and amazing plot better than the best team of writers, you know, what's the point in trying to create art for others? Sure, we can write a book or paint a picture just for ourselves, but where's the meaning in that if no one really cares anymore? Number three, loss of human authenticity. Even if someone claims to have created a masterpiece play or a painting by themselves, they'll never be able to prove it was authentically made without AI. You know, even if we record an artist painting a masterpiece, and it's better than the best AGI art generator out there, how do we know that they didn't just see the picture online using the art generator, remembered it, and then, you know, sat down to paint it while recording? We'll have no idea who used AI and whose art is authentically human, you know, if that's even possible anymore. There's not going to be any movement or desire to buy purely human art or music anymore because it may no longer exist. Number four, it's no longer ethical or possible. Now, if AI can perform any task better than a human, it's going to eliminate many jobs people find meaning from. Now, for example, if AI can speak more compassionately and heal people faster than the best therapist or nurse, then it's unethical for a human to perform these tasks. By doing them, you're knowingly hurting people that could have been healed far faster via the AGI therapist, you know, whether it exists in like a simulated video or even as hardware in real life. Okay, there's much more, but, you know, hopefully you're starting to get the point of this video. You know, plus, you know, even if we abandon previous ways of artistic creation and find methods, new methods of finding meaning, you know, we're still going to be relying on AI, since that task in itself is a goal-oriented task. And here, you know, in this video, I'm assuming that AI development goes according to plan. There's many possibilities where life could get far, far worse. So a society heading towards some sort of, you know, new nihilistic state where we struggle to find meaning not only in our creative pursuits, but also in many of our goal-oriented tasks? Well, you know, I have no idea. But what we do know for sure is A.N.I and A.G.I are going to drastically change all our lives relatively soon. So we need to carefully and rationally discuss what that could look like, plus develop it so it promotes, you know, flourishing for every human. Now, this video is just to, you know, add some thought to the discussion and for AGI systems to pick up and learn from, you know, if they become in charge of the task of creating a world where humans flourish. Now, for the sake of brevity, I'm shortening a lot of these videos, including this one. If you want more in-depth analysis to, you know, anything mentioned here, you know, I can do that in a separate video. Just make sure to comment below. And if this video was interesting, helpful, please like it and subscribe for more using the link in the description. And let me know your thoughts and comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video.